I have created a spreadsheet hat generator file for those of you that do not like math. And believe me, there's times I don't like math either. And I do go back to a lot of my spreadsheets to create a pattern for me. So the red here is for your information, your machine, the tension dial set in, the rib tension dial set in if you have the double bed. And here I have sample measurements. Now here, for a slouchy hat, you're going to add more rows. The hat size, I'm going to do a child, 18 inches. The height of the hat, 7.5 inches. Now if I want slouchy, I can go to 8, 8.5 on this one. Your stitches per inch, your rows per inch, and how tall you want the cuff to be. I like 2 inches with the rib. So the pattern tells me to cast on 90 stitches. I am going to rib or reform 12 rows. I do like to hand rib as well as working the crown by hand, but if you're going to use the machine, you know how to do all that stuff. Knitter only, you're going to reform. If you have a ribber, you're going to use the double bed. If you want a folded hem on the knitter only, you need to double that up here for 24 rows. If you're going to work a picot hem, this is probably going to end up being 25 rows for that one extra row you need. Also on the folded hem, sometimes I will knit the 12 rows, one row with the tension dial up a bit, or even turn in the work around with a garter bar to make that ridge, knit the one row, turn it around again, and go back, or turn the tension dial back, and go back to the next 12 rows. So with the double hem, you're going to hang the first row onto the needles. I did that with the hand rib. Then it tells me to work 46 rows stockinette stitch. Now for the crown. You've got three tabs down here to work the crown. The four-point crown, which I have pictures up on my site. The pencil top crown, which I think I may have put a picture up of that. If not, I'll try to get it on. And then the spiral crown. And each one of, and this is the one I prefer. And as you see, starting stitches goes back to the hat of what you have. Where are you? Right here. And then, now how many decreases do I want to do? I have it set up as 8. So I'm going to have 8 sections to the spiral. If I want 6 decreases, I change it to 6, press enter. Oops, I don't know why it did that. Let me try something. 6. There we go. For some reason, it's adding a decimal point in there. I'll have to figure this out and see what I did wrong. So then it's decreased every 14 and 15 stitches together. On the machine, you're going to move the 14th stitch to the 15th needle. Count across and do that. And of course, you're going to have it 6 times. Move all the stitches inward so you have no empty needles on the bed. On the machine, of course, you're going to knit 2 rows. By hand, I would purl a row after this decrease row. And as you see here, you got 14, 13, 15, 14. Each decrease row is going to be one less than the last decrease row. So the one after that is going to be 12 and 13, and so on. So again, on the machine, you knit 2 rows. By hand, you're just going to purl a row. Decrease as above until you get about 10 stitches. I think I ended up with 14 stitches on my last one. So the next row, I did a knit 2 together for the last to give me 7 stitches on the end. I did a gather bind off and then sewn the seam. wove in all the tail ends. And that's it.